Hey boys and girls, Mikey and Wongo ShortPlay. Tonight we are playing a game I loved on the Mega Drive and on the Amiga. And I'm wondering if this is going to be a faithful version, because I know that the SNES version is different. Although I think it was made by the same people. No, couldn't have done it. Well, they made the same game. I'm sure they have the reasons. Anyway, this looks different already. With the pattern and stuff, and the music's kind of a bit more arcadey. It's 8v3. Oh, that's the same. It's gonna be, oh, interesting. This is, I think, more based on the Mega Drive game and the Amiga game. It's not as good, I'd say that now, but you know, it's because it's the NES game. Its weapon selection is very different. If you're on a ladder, you drop grenades. I line a bomb! Okay, I'm just getting used to bombs. Is that the computer thing? Yeah, it's not very obvious, is it? Face hugger. Were they even in the Mega Drive version? I don't think they were, you know. It's very colourful. It's a very colourful bleak world, isn't it? It's loosely a port of the Mega Drive version. It's got a lot of the same stuff in it, which is cool. Whoa, it's that slidey bit. But rendered in a kind of cartoony way. It just doesn't really. That's gonna leave a mark. That wasn't in the Mega Drive version, I can tell you that now. It does have a feel though of the Mega Drive version. I've said the Mega Drive version too many times. Let's see the Amiga version. The 16-bit versions that aren't Nintendo. Ooh, it's a totally different map. It's got some of the same features though as that version. Those versions. As in, those annoying maps that you kind of end up in the same places on. It's clearly based on it. It's got that lovely, lovely bit of graphics with the aliens. Drooling face, which I think is essential to this game really, isn't it? What the chips was that? Down, my friend. I'm up now. Okay, we're out of trouble now. So that, thank goodness for that. Thank the gods of alien death. Yes. I don't know, I can't help but think though that if you were going for the pose of the Mega Drive, why didn't they make it look more like the Mega Drive? You know, like the Ripley frame there is a bit. You know the way they did double dragon ports? Oh hello, finally! You know the way they did double dragon ports on the NES? And they were clearly nothing like double dragon. This feels a bit like that. Well, you know, they were like double dragon, but they weren't double dragon. And they were kind of pretending to be double dragon. They were like pretenders to the double dragon throne. That said, they were brilliant, and I'm looking forward to playing them, because they're just different games in their own right. That's a shut door. Are you cheating the old? Oh, it's not. Okay, fair enough. I'm getting hammed. I don't know what hammed means. It's just a word I made up. Well, I didn't make it up, it's an existing word, clearly. But the context is, I don't even know what it means in that context. I kind of pictured being hit with a big piece of ham. Sorry, I'm in a bit of a funny mood tonight. I think I'm just really, really tired. I got up at 5 o'clock and went running. I don't know what's wrong with me. I quite look forward to it, you know, because I've done it 3 times now this week, and I got a bit of a bug for it. I'm not saying I'm like one of those boring people that goes running and talks about running and is uber healthy and eats all the right stuff, and it's just, oh! I don't think you wince when she falls over on distances. Oh, come on. That alien took a rocket in the face, and we all know it. Oh, I see. They take 2 rockets in the face now. Is that your little game, is it? See what he did there? I like the way. Oh, yeah, that was in the other versions. Nice. I'm going to do it again. That was harder. But yeah, I'll tell us where they are now. Yeah, I didn't think it would do this on the next version. I just thought it was one of those niceties that it wouldn't bother you. Where are they? Or is it just wandering into a map? Here we go. Chest burst. Let's grab the hood. Okay, we don't need to see that. Let's just move on. Wow, we've got to watch this. We don't get a choice to. It is actually telling us where they are, but I don't want to know. I want to find them. They're all kind of together, and I wasn't far from them. Yeah, that's a lovely rendition of that screen. Why can't the graphics in game look that good? Also, I love the way they tried to do Ripley's hair by dithering. And from the back view, it looks okay. And she's going down the ladder. But from the side view, it just looks like two pink pixels on the side of her head. Which is a bit silly, what's that? It's like some sort of death. Apparently so. But we can't go past the traffic lights. It's good though. I mean, it's a good game. In its own right, it's a good Alien 3 rendition. It is more like, as I say, the Mega Drive and the Amiga than it is more, and it is like the SNES version. And maybe it's not, maybe the SNES version is a bit more like this. But to my memory, it's more like the Mega Drive and the Amiga version. Alright, okay, so when those doors are shut, they've got little stripes on them. I don't want to fall down there. Don't. Oh, now I've got to fall down every, all that. And that. Oh, Jimmy. Jimmy's just clambered out of the kitchen, just emerged from the kitchen, making a lot of noise, creaking the door in the middle of the night. I say middle of the night, it's 10 o'clock, but everyone's gone to bed. And I'm being summoned as well. So I will be gone shortly because, let's face it, we've got a busy day tonight. I'm taking the Baba to his toddler sense group, and I'm taking the dogs here. There's two of them next to me on the couch. Charlie and Bailey. Ooh, to the vets. Oh, you heard that, did you? There was a twitch. A twitch of nervous recognition. They're not bothered. They're a bit crap with the dogs, so I get a bit tense when I take them to the vet. I know what that is. I'm jumping to it. Shoot the head. Oh, come on. So I can't actually do that. Oh, that's creepy. Oh my little Xeno. I can't shoot you. Oh, I'm going to do this. You're going to come down now? Oh, I see. You're just going to make life difficult. Right. See ya. Didn't like that. Oh no! Or that. Let's go down and get those guys before we run out of time. Although, I'm probably not going to make it. 1 minute 34. Ah, it's a face hugger. Panic. That was a proper panic. They are on the other version, aren't they? Oh, I think so. It's not a great rendition of mine, though. I can't really complain about this version. Hello. It does what? Pretty much what the other versions do. On a really big budget, if you like. But, it doesn't do a bad thing. Look, there's the dithered hair. Kind of works, except there's some lazy dithering going on there. And then, now it's just two pink pixels on the side of the red. Oh, I did exactly that again. I wonder if there's like a way of doing that without hurting yourself. I'd have to pull down and jump. Nah, that's a nice frame. Some of the frames kind of feel like the other versions, and some of them feel like badly drawn versions of them. It could have been better drawn, I think. Oh, cool. It's got that. I don't know though why they didn't design the maps to be the same. Because if you can do it, this all, you know, it's got all the functionality of the Mega Drive maps. Why did they insist on remaking the game just because it's the Nintendo version? I don't get that. I never got that about Nintendo. It's like they don't play well with others, you know. And the same goes for the developer deals and whatnot. They're always a bit awkward and difficult to work with, and I don't have breath for that stuff. And the games weren't necessarily better because, oh, it's the exit, isn't it? I'm dead. It's all gonna blow up in 2 seconds. 1 second. No seconds. Oh! Chest burst. Yeah, they didn't play well with others. And they didn't. I don't think, from what I'm finding, that the game's any better for it. If this was a perfect reenactment of Alien 3 for the Mega Drive and the Amiga, with slightly better graphics, I think it could do that. And with the maps from those versions, I think the maps in those versions are better and more fun. more intuitive. Maybe there's limitations to the NES and that's why they couldn't do it, but I don't know. I love that. That says a lot about what it can do. Look at it. Beautiful. Didn't stay on screen for long enough, in my opinion. It's a good game though. It's just, it's not as good as those versions. And those versions aren't amongst the very finest that the Mega Drive and the Amiga had to offer. Oh, I see it. The bomb thing. On those versions, you can shoot down with a gun. That's kind of nice. I don't know why you can't do it with versions. There's no reason not to. I'm going to go see if I can find it. Now, I know there's one there, but I'm going to go see if I can find it. Just because the principle of it, man. It's annoying that I can't find it. Is this that bit where I come face to face with one of dog, I think he's going to die. I don't mind the extra little features like the gun overheating and stuff. That's cool. I just don't know why you keep half the functions from the other games and add them. Load of new ones and a miss for load of other ones that the other versions have. Makes no sense. Doesn't seem like a very sensible, cost effective way to do things. Then again, Nintendo are the only ones that are going out of all of the already a bunch, so who am I to talk? I just feel the animations could have been a bit better. Could have been a bit more like the other versions. Good though. I mean, it's good. It's good. It's one of the better NES games I've played. It's one of the more solidly put together NES games that I've played. I'm looking forward to playing some of these absolute gems that people are talking about though. I'm not saying that with like sarcasm, I am genuinely looking forward to it. Because, you know, I want to play them. I want to one day maybe buy a few NES games from the NES. And I found a few oh, nice chunk. Wrong button, but I'll take that. Yeah, I want to buy some games from the NES eventually, if and when I can ever afford them. That literally might never happen. But I've done it again. Oh, nice landing. Nice landing, Rippers. You know, if ever I can afford them, I want to have like a list of a good kind of. I've limited myself to 50 Mega Drive games. I'd probably do something similar with NES games, but I don't think I'll need that many in the collection to feel like I've got all the ones I want. I'm really sweat first. It doesn't feel as good as the other versions. I'm calling the other versions now. I mean, I don't mean because it's an 8-bit version, because of that. That goes without saying. That's contexting. I'm all for a game being good in context. I can't handle the spectrum. There's some great games on that. But feel that they've redesigned the levels for this needlessly, unless they redesigned the levels for this one first, but I doubt that's enough. And the other versions feel sort of kind of put rather than not into the film, because the film is totally different to the games and there's backstory behind all that, which I won't go into it. But it feels like this version could have just copied the design, level design of the other ones. And they saved themselves a massive big job. You know, you didn't have to put all the time into redesigning or designing the whole new game, which is basically what they've done here. I've got some left to rescue, haven't I? Although, that said, I can't actually see anything that tells me there's anyone to rescue. I've got 30 seconds. I've got to find a way out of here. Well, did he die? Apparently not. Uh-oh. The other version of that guy would have been like that. I think there's probably one to the left, but I've got 14 seconds, guys. I'm going to try and get out of here if I can. 10 seconds. Oh, come on, tunnel. Come on, tunnel. Come on, tunnel. All right, go. Yes! Yes! That big. I think we'll just see the staff next time. I think, if I remember rightly, yeah, they're all kind of built on the same tile sets, but with different designs, which is cool. It worked on the other version. It's good though. It's good for the NES. I just don't see why they bothered redesigning levels for it, but you know, what do I know about the NES limitations? That was not bad. That was Alien 3 for the NES. Thanks for watching.